Hey everyone, this is ELPHNT. In this video, I want to show you a technique I use to generate chords, melodies, and bass lines when I'm feeling uninspired and stuck for ideas. The way it works is we'll let Live automatically generate a large range of musical ideas that we can then pick and choose our favorite parts from. So instead of having to think too much to come up with parts, we can let Live do all that work and then just sit back and choose the best bits. So to show you where we'll end up, I've already let Live generate a MIDI clip. You'll see I have this really long recording of various different chord progressions, and I've isolated a short section of it that I quite liked. But I can grab my loop brace and move it around the recording to choose from all the other options as well. At the moment, I just have a chord progression, but this will work for melodies and bass lines too. It's not too complicated to get this set up, so let's take a look at how to do that. We're going to take advantage of Live's flexible track routing. Any MIDI track in Live can send its output to the input of any other MIDI track. So you'll see I've got this track called MIDI Bus, and it's sending its MIDI to my synth track. That MIDI bus is receiving its MIDI from these three trigger tracks. Each of these trigger tracks has one MIDI clip with a single note on it. So you'll see if I trigger this clip, it's sending its MIDI information to my MIDI bus, which then sends it onto my synth to play a note. So that's not very exciting, but if I go over to my MIDI bus, you'll notice I've loaded up some of Live's MIDI effects. You can find these in Live's browser under the MIDI effects category, and I'm using the random, chord, and scale MIDI devices. First, let's enable the random device. The random MIDI device takes any MIDI notes that pass through it and randomizes their pitch. The chance that a note will be randomized is defined by this chance control. So if I set it to 100%, every MIDI note that passes through this track will have its pitch randomized. So you'll now hear that every time my note plays, I have a random pitch. The next step is our chord device. This takes an incoming single note and creates a chord. The chord is defined by the intervals we set up here, and for this technique, you can pretty much go with anything. So now we're getting chords triggered by this random note, but there's one more step. Our chords are not in any particular musical key, which, unless you're making some kind of atonal music, is probably not what you want. So in comes our last MIDI effect, the scale effect. And for this one, I'm using the C minor preset. If I hit the hot swap button on the scale device, it'll take me to the presets browser for that device where I can choose from various other scale types. So the scale MIDI device takes incoming MIDI notes and maps them all to a specific key, which is exactly what we want. So now we have these randomly generating chords in the key of C minor, but at the moment the rhythm is not particularly interesting, so this is where our other triggers come in. If I go into the clip on trigger 2, you'll see I also have just a single MIDI note, but it's in a slightly different timing to trigger 1. You'll also notice that my clip's loop is a different length to my first trigger. What this means is that when these two clips are played together, they'll start to generate a polyrhythm. Trigger 2 is also sending its MIDI to my MIDI bus, so if I play the second clip, You'll notice I'm still getting my semi-random chords, but I've got this non-repeating semi-generative rhythm as well. If I want to make this rhythm a little more complex, I can add my third trigger clip, which also has a slightly different timing and loop to my first two clips. I could keep going and add as many triggers as I want for increasingly complex rhythms, but three is fine for now. So now my last step is to hit record on a clip in my synth track. And it just sees all this MIDI input as any other regular MIDI input and records it into the clip. So I'll just let this record for a little while. Okay, so now we have this long stretch of generated chords, but to have a good chord progression, we need some kind of repetition. So I can go into the loop and set my loop brace to a more sensible length. I'll also want to make sure to stop my trigger tracks, otherwise my synth will still be receiving input from them as well as the clip. So I've put all my triggers into a group to be able to start and stop them easily. Now if I select my loop brace, I can move it around within my clip and start finding chord progressions I like. And of course, because these are all just recorded as MIDI notes, if I find something that's pretty close to what I like, I can just go in and edit the notes. From here, it's pretty easy to get to melodies and bass lines. If I go back to my MIDI bus, I can just disable the chord effect and I'll start getting melodies. I can use the transpose control in my scale device to pitch it up or pitch it down to get bass lines. Let's maybe load up a different bass sound. And I can just change the routing of my MIDI bus to send to my new bass track. So I use this technique all the time if I'm feeling stuck for parts, and I find it's really useful to just get going with the first step, and from there more ideas start to flow. I've put together a template set that I can quickly load up to start generating ideas. The template set has everything pre-set up, so you can load it up and get straight to generating parts. I've included a link to download the template in the description below this video. I've also added an interactive lesson to the template that should load up when you open it, so you can follow along with the instructions to get started using the pattern generator. There's a bunch more that we can do with this technique to create more interesting patterns, like using follow actions to get more randomization, or dummy clips to create more interesting chords. Some of that's included in the template, but let me know in the comments if you'd like to see more of this. Hopefully you find this technique useful in your productions. Please let me know what you think in the comments. And of course, if there are any questions, please leave them in the comments as well, and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. If you enjoyed the video, please share it with your friends, and also don't forget to hit the subscribe button. If you're not there already, head to ELPHNT.co.za to check out more tutorials and to download some Ableton Live packs. Thanks for watching.